It's gonna be a Cinefanatics reaction to a Dune trailer. Things are gonna get a little spicy. Spicier than the sands of Arrakis.
Dune.
Feel better?
Welcome to the Son of Fanatics. My name's Robert Adams.
I'm Chris Adams.
And today, we've got a trailer for Dune Part 2.
Coffee,
Java. Yeah. Always got to put in a George of the Jungle reference in my Dune trailer reaction if I can, you know?
That's what everyone coming onto YouTube is expecting whenever they search for trailer reactions to
Dune
Part 2.
If you're not putting a George of the Jungle...
You're behind. Catch up.
I mean, what are you doing with your life? How are you making videos on YouTube? We got a Dune trailer to watch.
Okay, so obviously we know this is the sequel to the first Dune. Not the first Dune. This is part two to the Dune that
part
isn't
one.
The first Dune, but it's a part one of Dune.
That one, yes, it connects, yes.
Made by Denis Villeneuve.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, here's the thing. Dune, we saw the first part of Dune in the theater. It's good. It's how the people say the word they were using to describe it at that time, dense. It's very dense.
That makes sense.
That was the word that was going around, and there's a reason for that. There's a lot packed in there, and it doesn't hold your hand. It's like, hey, just get on board. This is who that is. This is who that is. This is where we're going. This is what they're doing. Deal with it.
It's a good thing they made a part two of this.
And yeah, and for those of us who don't read the books, don't read in books generally, we like movies. Not that the two actually are a competing
thing.
We're
not the Book of Fanatics.
We're just not as big on reading as much as some people. There's a lot that kind of gets lost. So all this to say, you kind of have an expectation of what our reaction might be here. I did like the first Dune, though. I will say that real quick. Dune Part 1 was good. It's a good movie. I really want to see what's in store for Dune Part 2, though, because there is some stuff that I'm actually excited to see, regardless of not really knowing the lore.
I now understand why you don't talk so much before we watch the trailer.
Let's get in.
It's breathtaking.
No, you're breathtaking.
Stand here, imagine water. If you dive in, you can't reach the bottom.
This is the best part of the whole video.
In. Yes, cold swimming.
I don't believe you.
I hate sand.
It's rough and coarse. It gets everywhere. Arrakis
lie many secrets. But the darkest of them all may remain.
Hey.
All right, sold. Florence Pugh's in this.
Yep.
The end of House Atreides.
Your father didn't believe in revenge.
What if Paul Atreides were still alive?
Yes.
Is that Austin Butler's character?
Yeah, Austin Butler is Freya.
Question on everyone's mind is, will he wear a Speedo?
Dream about your first ride.
Oh, he's gonna ride the worm.
You're brave, we all know that. Be simple. Be direct.
Okay.
That looks terrifying.
I understand.
Come on, ride the worm. And ride it.
Oof. Nah, son, you fancy. You fancy for that.
That's cool.
Worm surfing. That's dope.
Yeah.
You will never lose me, Paul Atreides.
We gave them something to hope for.
That's not hope!
May thy knife chip and shatter.
Ooh.
Yeah. All right.
Well, that looks boring.
Well, shut up. No, this what this trailer does for me immediately is makes me want to watch the first one again.
Yeah.
I want to watch the first one again. I'm probably going to wait and rewatch it right before we go see the this one.
That way it's still kind of like fresh.
That way it's fresh and I can just, boom, continue on with all the lore and everything. Because here's the thing. I am a big fan of this series' spiritual offspring, Star Wars. And because of that, I am automatically attracted to the things that Dune is doing.
Especially when they put Florence Pugh in it.
Especially when they put Florence Pugh in it. But now you just threw me off. No, but there's sci-fi elements to this that are familiar because obviously Dune came before Star Wars, kind of influenced it a little bit.
Well, as movie-wise, yes. I believe the book still came first.
Yes. But. Yeah. So a lot of the influences. So there's stuff here that they're doing that I'm like, yeah, I want to see that. Big armies, sci-fi fighting, cool creatures like the worm, all this stuff.
Yeah.
I want to see all this stuff. So I'm kind of excited for this.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen the original, the David Lynch 84 Dune. And I remember, like, I've seen that and watching Dune Part 1. And I kind of, there's definitely some things in there I can remember, like where they lay at, how they come together. Mm-hmm. I'm not exactly sure what parts out of the David Lynch Dune I'm really connecting with this part too, other than obviously Freya. I know it sounds like it should be like the second half of the movie, essentially, fighting for the revolution of the Fremen or something like that.
Which does look like that's the direction it's going in.
Yeah, but I don't remember like the specific connections in the original movie. So that might be, I don't know. I agree I want to watch part one again. I don't know if I'm kind of thinking about watching the 84 Dune again, but I don't know if I want to do that much. That's a lot of Dune.
Hey, you know.
And Dune is pretty, it's pretty out there.
Yeah.
So, especially if it's done by David Lynch.
Especially also if you haven't read the books.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I might give it another shot, but who knows? Depends on time.
Yeah, it looks good. I'm interested. I can't wait to see, you know, kind of where it goes. I know we got like hints in the first movie about kind of like the future. Like it showed us the future and the direction of where it's going. And kind of like the whole sci-fi battle action side of it is what really intrigues me. Because that stuff is what like gets me in a lot of movies.
Yeah.
So that's kind of what I'm looking forward to here. Obviously, we're going to have a lot of people in the comments hanging out, telling us, you know, what their experiences are with Dune and what they liked about it and everything.
Well, you guys don't read the books? You haven't watched the movie? What?
Yeah. I mean, it happens. You know, we represent many, many people who are the same exact way.
I represent all the people.
Yes. So...
all of them.
we are very interested. Let us know down in the comments below. What is your connection to Dune? What does it mean to you? And you know, what are your favorite aspects of it? What are you looking forward to in the Dune sequel? Let's have that conversation in the comments.
And while you're down there, make sure you also hit the like button and the subscribe button because, well, that's our reaction. So let us know what you think. Also, follow us on social media at Twitter and Instagram at TheCineFanatics. And you can also follow me personally at Robert Adams MLP on Twitter, Instagram, Letterboxd, and YouTube.com/@RobertAdamsMLP.
And you can follow me at Chris Adams MLP on Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd, as well as Twitch.tv/ChrisAdamsMLP.
Anyways, that's going to be our reaction. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next one. Now it's time to go get some more coffee because I need to wake the hell up. Jabba, 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 jabba.
Some connection to a weapon of choice. I wanted to reference that in some way.
Okay.
Weapon of choice. Ooh, Christopher Walken.